Welcome to St. Mary's in the Valley Episcopal Church in Ramona, California. My name is Phil Cook, Vicar of St. Mary's. Today we will read perhaps the most famous verse in the New Testament, John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. As painful as living in the world can sometimes be, we need to have this love from God to love this world as God loves it. Lent is a time for us to practice learning how to get into the flow of God's love for this world and for the people in it. The gospel is always an invitation to God's love. Thank you for joining us for this liturgy today. Holy Eucharist continues on page 355. Bless the Lord who forgives all our sins. God's mercy endures forever. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Look around you, can you see? Times are troubled, people grieve. See the violence, feel the hardness. All my people weep with me. Kyrie eleison, Christe eleison, Kyrie eleison. Walk among them, I'll go with you. Reach out to them with my hands. Suffer with me, and together we will serve them, help them stand. Kyrie eleison, Christe. Hear our prayer. We would walk with you anywhere. Through your suffering, with forgiveness, take your life into the world. Kyrie eleison, Christe.
Gracious Father, whose blessed Son, Jesus Christ, came down from heaven to be the true bread which gives life to the world, evermore give us this bread, that he may live in us and we in him, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
A reading for the fourth Sunday in Lent from Numbers. From Mount Hor, the Israelites set out by the way to the Red Sea to go around the land of Edom, but the people became impatient on the way. The people spoke against God and against Moses. "Why have you brought us out of Egypt to die in the wilderness? For there is no food and no water, and we detest this miserable food." Then the Lord sent poisonous serpents among the people, and they bit the people so that many Israelites died. The people came to Moses and said, "We have sinned by speaking against the Lord and against you. Pray to the Lord to take away the serpents from us." So Moses prayed for the people, and the Lord said to Moses, "Make a poisonous serpent and set it on a pole, and everyone who is bitten shall look at it and live." So Moses made a serpent of bronze and put it upon a pole. And whenever a serpent bit someone, that person would look at the serpent of bronze and live. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thanks be to God.
Psalm 107 for the fourth Sunday in Lent. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, and his mercy endures forever. Let all those whom the Lord has redeemed proclaim that he redeemed them from the hand of the foe. He gathered them out of the lands, from the east and from the west, from the north and from the south. Some were fools and took to rebellious ways. They were afflicted because of their sins. They abhorred all manner of food and drew near to death's door. Then they cried to the Lord in their trouble, and he delivered them from their distress. He sent forth his word and healed them and saved them from the grave. Let them give thanks to the Lord for his mercy and the wonders he does for his children. Let them offer a sacrifice of thanksgiving and tell of his acts with joy, with shouts of joy.
The epistle for the fourth Sunday in Lent is from the book of Ephesians. You were dead through the trespasses and sins in which you once lived, following the course of this world, following the ruler of the power of the air, the spirit that is now at work among those who are disobedient. All of us once lived among them in the passions of our flesh, following the desires of flesh and senses, and we were by nature children of wrath, like everyone else. God, who is rich in mercy, out of the great love with which he loved us, even when we were dead through our trespasses, made us alive together with Christ. By grace you have been saved, and raised us up with him, and seated us with him in the heavenly places in Christ Jesus, so that in the ages to come he might show the immeasurable riches of his grace in kindness toward us in Christ Jesus. For by grace you have been saved through faith, and this is not your own doing, it is the gift of God, not the result of works, so that no one may boast. For we are what he has made us, created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God prepared beforehand to be our way of life. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thanks be to God.
Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. Glory to you, Lord Christ. Jesus said, just as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, so must the Son of Man be lifted up, that whoever believes in him may have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish but have eternal life. Indeed, God did not send the Son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved through him. Those who believe in him are not condemned, because those who do not believe are condemned already, because they have not believed in the name of the only Son of God. And this is the judgment, that the light has come into the world, and people love darkness rather than light, because their deeds were evil. For all who do evil hate the light and do not come to the light, so that their deeds may not be exposed. But those who do what is true come to the light, so that it may be clearly seen that their deeds have been done in God. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Christ. The appointed Bible readings for today present quite a contrast in how God's people understood God and God's intervention in response to human behaviors. Imagine yourself as a parent with children who complained about the food you served or about what they got to drink. What kind of parent would you be if you said, "Okay, kids, I'm tired of your complaining. Tonight you're going to be locked in your room with a nest of poisonous snakes." Well, if you did this, you might get reported to Child Protective Services. But what about God, the heavenly parent, and the children of Israel who complained about food and water to Moses? God sent as punishment for this complaining people poisonous snakes to bite and kill many of them. Moses interceded and was instructed to put a bronze serpent on a pole for the disobedient children to look at and be healed. Not a hard task. You could accept healing just by looking at the snake image on the pole. In crueler times, this story seems to be a story that an older brother would tell to a younger sibling, as what would happen if they didn't clean their plate and drink their milk. You better eat your food, or you know what happened to those complaining children of Israel a long, long time ago. Now fast forward to our New Testament readings, and we find a contrast in how God is presented in the New Testament writings. God so loved the world, and God gave us Jesus as a way to know the gift of everlasting life, in this life by the Holy Spirit and in the age to come as well. And we are saved by grace through faith. And further, according to St. Paul, we are lifted up to be seated in heavenly places with Christ. I would suggest that the Bible readings present quite an evolution in how people have understood God and God's interactions with us. I think we can be thankful that the best presentation has been saved for the last. We don't have to face poisonous snakes for our sins, for our shortcomings, our ignorance, and our underdeveloped moral and spiritual lives. But what do the words of Jesus retain from the bronze serpent on the pole story? It was only the glance of faith which healed. And that is how the cross functioned for St. Paul and the gospel writers. If sin is the poisonous snakes which rob us of good living, then just look at the cross of Jesus where he is lifted up. Look with the glance of faith. Well, that's easy, you say. And isn't that the point of grace? It's as difficult as simply taking it. People who are prideful in the habit of turning down, or more often not recognizing the gifts that they have been given, persons of sinful pride think, "I don't need gifts. I am self-made. I go it alone. I don't need you. I don't need God's grace. I am an island of independence." But this is the illusion of the state of sin, being born within all of the provisions of the world and with the image of God upon our lives, and falsely believing that we are the ones who made this happen. The purpose of the life of Jesus is to convince us of grace and of the total gift of God that has been towards us in creation itself. And what are we to do? We are to learn how to revel in God's goodness and abundant gifts all around us. And we are to learn that abundant goodness can be inside of us too, in grace, love, peace, and joy. All those delicious, wonderful free gifts. But what we need to learn is to get the ego out of the way, to merely learn how to take the glance of faith and receive and access the gifts. Another thing we need to learn is about grace and condemnation. Saving grace or condemnation is inherent in how we act or behave. We don't have to wait for future punishments or for God to release poisonous snakes. When we do what is wrong, it is the manifestation of condemnation itself. That we do wrong is its own punishment. Conversely, grace and salvation are immediately inherent and self-reinforcing. The reward of grace and salvation when we act in faith to do what is right is that we get to be good, loving, kind, and just. The reward of grace is immediate. Wow, we get to be nice and kind. And that is salvation and grace. What you and I can learn from John 3:16 is that God loves the world. And God has hidden that love in each of us, and all we have to do is let it out. And as we give the gift of love, we receive more of the supply of love, because it is all about the flow of God's love through us. And that is the secret of poetically being seated with Christ in the heavenly places. When we can love with the gift of God's love through us, that is what heaven on earth means. Amen. We continue with the Nicene Creed found on page 358. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Embraced by God's word, let us intercede for all those in need, saying, "Have mercy, O Lord." For the church, that our Lenten hunger may be for justice and our thirst for deeds of justice, we pray. Have mercy, O Lord. For the church, that all those to be baptized at Easter may see through the dazzling attractions of sin and rejoice only in God's marvelous gift, we pray. Have mercy, O Lord. For the community of nations, that the worth of every life may compel us on the way to solidarity and peace, we pray. Have mercy, O Lord. For exiles and refugees, that all who are homeless because of war or hunger, because of the greed or hatred of others, because of disabilities, may find places of rest and kindness, we pray. Have mercy, O Lord. For those who struggle with addictions, that they may find strength and love for the simple gifts of God, we pray. Have mercy, O Lord. For this assembly, God's handiwork, that our steps be directed in ways of peace that lead us to the side of those the world despises, and that we name these rejected ones our brothers and sisters, we pray.
Have mercy, O Lord.
Here other intercessions may be offered.
Michael's family.
God, full of goodness and open to weakness, remember all whom we remember and remind us of all whom we would forget. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
Oh.
continues on page 361. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give God thanks and praise. It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who was tempted in every way as we are, yet did not sin. By his grace we are able to triumph over every evil and to live no longer for ourselves alone, but for him who died for us and rose again. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Father, in your infinite love, you made us for yourself. And when we had fallen into sin and become subject to evil and death, you in your mercy sent Jesus Christ, your own and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. When he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died,
Christ is risen.
We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, the sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at the last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ. By him and with him and in him in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is. This day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all that is evil, for thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Amen.
Our Passover is sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast. The gifts of God for the people of God, take them in remembrance that Christ died for you. Feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. Post-communion prayer is found on page 365. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you always. Amen. Let us go forth in the name of Christ. Thanks be to God.